Today we shall find out the velocity of transverse wave along a stretched string. So in this we consider a string like this, which is fixed at both the ends, and this string has got uniform cross-sectional area, and also the mass per unit length of this string is constant. Now, when this string is plucked here, somewhere at the middle, what will happen? The string will vibrate in the transverse direction. So, we have made the diagram of this string here. This AB is the undisplaced position of the string, which is along the x-axis, and APQB is the displaced position of the string at suppose some time t. We have taken x-axis along the direction of the undisplaced position of the string, and the displacement is along AY, that is Y axis. We have also considered a very small element of the string del S between two neighboring points P and Q. Now remember, this is the displaced position of the string, and tension is acting at the point P and also at this point Q. Here, at point P, the tension is acting along this direction, and at point Q, the tension is acting along this direction, tension T. Also, we consider this element del S to be very small, so we can consider this element to be straight for all practical purpose. Also, the amplitude of vibration is small, therefore this theta is very small. Now, for finding the velocity of the transverse wave along the stretched string, what we will do? We will resolve the component of the tension along the horizontal direction at P and along the vertical direction at P, and we will do the same, that is resolve the component of the tension T at the point Q along the horizontal direction and also along the vertical direction. Now we start with resolving the component of the tension T at point P. Resolving the component of tension T at P along horizontal direction. So what it is? Here the direction of tension is this direction, this angle is theta. So along the horizontal direction it is T cos theta, and the direction being along the direction X A. Since theta is small, we can write it as T, and this is along X A. Now the vertical component. So the vertical component is along the direction y a, and this is given by t sine theta. Now since theta is 1, so we can write it as t tan theta, and this is equal to t dy by dx, where dy by dx is the tangent, is the slope of the tangent at this point P. So this is equation number 1. Now we resolve the component of tension at this point Q along horizontal direction and along this vertical direction. Component of tension T at Q along horizontal direction, and this is again equal to T, and this time this is along A x. So the component of tension along at point P and Q along the horizontal direction is equal and opposite, and so there is no motion along the x axis, since at P the horizontal component is T acting along x A, and at this point Q the horizontal component of tension is T, which is acting along A x. X and x are opposite to each other. Now we shall find the vertical component of this tension at this point Q. So at P, the vertical component was this much, T dy by dx. At P, vertical component of tension at P was equal to T dy by dx. Now the rate of change of this vertical component along x direction is d dx of T dy by dx. Therefore, the change in the vertical component of tension in going from P to Q, that is del x along x axis, is given by d dx of T dy by dx into del x. And since this del x is almost equal to del s, we can write it as t dx of t dy by dx and del s. Therefore, the component of the tension in the vertical direction at this point Q will be given by T dy by dx plus d dx of t, dy by dx del s. So vertical component of tension T at Q is equal to T dy by dx plus T by dx T dy by dx del s, and this is equal to T dy by dx plus T d2y by dx square del s, and let this be equation 2. Therefore, the resultant tension at this point Q is given by T dy by dx plus T d2y by dx square del s, the vertical component of tension acting at the point Q, minus the vertical component of the tension acting at P, which is in this direction. So T dy by dx, and this cancels out. So this is equal to T d2y bar dx square del s. Now this is the element del s. Let the mass per unit length of the string be small m. Let mass per unit length of the string be small m. Therefore, mass of this element del s from P to Q is m del s, and the force acting on this element del s will be equal to mass into acceleration, and acceleration is how much? d2y by dt square. So this force and this force must be equal. That is the only resultant force acting along the positive y direction here, that is along a y. So it is equated m del s d2y by dt square is equal to t d2y by dx square del s. So from here we get this d2y by dt square is equal to t by m d2y by dx square, as this delta s and del s gets cancelled out. So we have d2y by dt square is equal to t by m d2y by dx square. Now we have the differential wave equation of the progressive wave as equal to d2i by dt square is equal to v square d2i by dx square, where this v square is the square of the velocity of the wave. So comparing this equation and this equation, from here we get v equal to, that is the velocity of the wave, v equal to under root t by m, where this t is the tension and this mass, this is m, that is mass per unit length. Therefore, from here we see that the velocity of the transverse wave along its stretch field is proportional to the square root of this tension t and is inversely proportional to the square root of mass per unit length. So we shall stop here.